Mully at Hall, Chicago Sports Radio 6-7 of the Score. On the line is Odyssey NFL Insider Brian Baldinger. Insider calls are presented by BetQL. Subscribe to BetQL today. Instantly get the model's best bets, live public and sharp data, trends, and much more right at your fingertips. You can also hear Brian with Jason LaConfora on Baldy's Breakdowns with new episodes out every week. Just search Baldy on the Odyssey app or wherever you find your podcasts. And Brian joins us now on the Signature Bank Score Hotline. Signature Bank, making commercial banking personal. Brian, good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great, guys. It's good to be with you again. Thank you.
Well, we love talking to you, and I love watching your breakdowns, and I really appreciated some of the kind words you had for different Bears players. You're getting a kick out of the development of Justin Fields and the plays that he's making, and I heard you talking about the linebacker too, Jack Sanborn, Jack Hammer, I believe they're calling him. You know, just it's made a losing season fun seeing what Fields is doing.
Well, I mean, you're seeing the development of a real quarterback. And so while he's developing, he's entertaining as hell. And you're in all these games, and you're scoring a lot of points, and nobody runs the football like the Bears do. And he's at the forefront. And you can just see his confidence growing, and his confidence, as his confidence has grown, the offense is opened up, and it's developing. And you can't fix everything at once. But if you get this quarterback straight and fixed and working, this thing is going to be a build. It's going to be a quick build, the way we've seen in Buffalo and some other places around the league. You got to start there. And I think they've done a fantastic job with him. You've all seen it from, you know, the monsoon against San Francisco week one when he made a couple plays and won a game. And you've lost these games, but you're in these games. And so, I don't know. I watched this quarterback play. I think there's a bright, bright future in Chicago.
Baldy, how much of that is related to his just extraordinary talent and special skill set? And how much of that is because you've got an offensive line that has been much maligned, but you look now 10 games in, they lead the NFL in rushing. They may have struggles protecting the passer, but that development and that improvement has also coincided with Justin Fields' emergence. How much credit do you give the offensive line?
A lot. I mean, you know, Braxton Jones is a rookie, and he doesn't look like a rookie right now. He's a physically tough kid. He moves well. He's playing good football. I mean, I want to say Tevin Jenkins, but Schofield was in there last week. I mean, everybody knows Cody Whitehair is a tough guy. You want him on your offensive line. I don't care if he's playing center guard. He makes a difference when he's in the lineup right now. So, yeah, they played well up front. They played well, and they moved the line of scrimmage, and you know, I mean, they've run for 1,200 yards in the last 5 weeks. Like 1,200. I mean, there's some teams that might not run for that all year. They've done it in the last 5 weeks here. Now, the quarterback's a big part of it, but, you know, they're 1-2 punch with Montgomery and Herbert. And I know Herbert's down, but, I mean, he's a really good back. Montgomery is just kind of a special kid. I mean, it's a good group. It's a good group. And Justin's threat to run the ball really opens things up in some ways, but the tight ends are blocking good. I mean, look, if you can hang your hat on something in this business and just be the best at something, it's going to make a difference. The Giants got their hands full this week.
Yeah, you know, I think that there is a question, and I don't know if it's a big question or not, but how many like player procurement periods does it take to get to a playoff caliber? I mean, you could argue that the Bears, if a couple of these results had gone the other way, and they very, very nearly could have, they could be in the playoff picture right now. But how long do you think it's going to take for this team to, if indeed the quarterback is correct, as we all believe right now, that makes it a much shorter distance, right?
Well, they need one great draft. I mean, you know, Seattle's in the playoff picture. They had one great draft. I mean, you go around the league, the Jets had a great draft during the playoff picture. I mean, it takes one great draft right now. If the quarterback is right, and I believe it, I thought he was the best quarterback coming out of that draft. I thought San Francisco made a mistake. The Bears got lucky. This kid is just special. You put one good draft around Justin Fields, and you mix it in offense, defense, you need a pass rusher. There's some things you need. But you get one great draft, and you combine that with good free agency selections, I mean, you're going to be in the playoff picture.
So outside of Halas Hall, Baldy, we can have all of the praise for Justin Fields and apply all the superlatives and exaggerate maybe what's happening, but it is special and it's so much fun. If you're coaching him, what do you think is his next phase of improvement? What would you like to see him do better? Or do you think that you just continue to reinforce what he does well and this is good enough? But I think there's still some room to grow. Where is that growth going to take place?
Well, it's pre-snap. What are they doing? What are they trying to do to me? Knowing how they're going to try to defend him in the run game. Are they spying him? Are they must rushing him? All the different techniques out there to try to corral a player of his ability. The Lions tried to do a lot of that stuff. Didn't make any difference. He shredded him. So, I mean, just recognizing some of the things that they're going to do pre-snap makes your job once the ball is snapped a lot easier. But I think Luke Getsy is, that guy is up for coach of the year if there's such a thing for an offense coordinator. Because they're doing a lot of things, kind of whether it's short yardage plays or the throws to Cole Kmet right now for touchdowns. They're just doing things that really kind of sell the run and then get them to bite on that and then kind of throw a little wrench at them. So they're doing a lot of stuff during the week, game to game, just game planning right now that's really working. I don't think it's going to stop. So once you know the quarterback can really see the field and he's going through his progressions really well right now, the Lions giving him time to do it at times. So I just think it's just playing. Just keep playing. Just keep learning. You can see the confidence growing week to week right now. And so as the confidence grows, that grows because of success. So, ultimately, if you say, okay, well, what's next? Well, win games. Just win games. That's what really builds a whole team confidence. You can see the offense growing, but you got to win games now. And so the Giants are a really good football team. I just saw them last week. They don't beat themselves. They're really big in the middle of the defensive line. They run the ball really well. I mean, it'd be great to go to New York and win a game against a really good football team, really sound and well-coached. That would be the next step.
Do you want to see that happen before the year? Because here in Chicago, everybody wants the quarterback to play well and the draft pick to be as high as humanly possible. And the thinking is, look at what Miami did, right? They traded down and then they used those picks to go back up and get Waddle and then use one to trade for the cheetah, Tyreek Hill, and then use one to bring in a pass rusher this year. It just seems like that is the fantasy football going on in the minds of Bears fans.
I don't know. Sometimes that can work. I mean, you look at really the whole haul of what the Dolphins did. I mean, they traded Laremy Tunsil away and, they did all this stuff. Well, they still went out and paid Teron Armstead to be their left tackle because they didn't get it right. They still went out and gave Connor Williams a whole bunch of money to play center because they didn't get it right. So, yes, Waddle is there as a result. But they also kind of flittered away a bunch of draft picks because they didn't draft well. So, I mean, I could argue some of that. But I don't agree with that. I don't agree. I'm not saying tank. I don't agree with any of that stuff. Like, you can find good players in the draft at any position, at any number, in any round. You got to find them. And you got to beat other teams to it. So, to me, if I was Chicago, I'd try to win as many games as I possibly can. And if that means I'm not in the playoffs and we're not in a great draft position, we're drafting number 20 instead of number 5, I don't care. Like, go find good players at number 20. And you could do that. You just got to draft well.
Great stuff. Yep.
Great stuff. Real quick, last one. You mentioned Luke Getsy and his impact. When you watch the Bears on tape, you watch a lot of teams on film. He resisted the idea that he borrowed some or copied some plays from the Ravens or from here or from there. Do you see similarities between what the Bears are doing in other teams, or is this an original product from Luke Getsy?
I think it's pretty original. I mean, I think Cole Kmet might end up with 10, 12 touchdown catches the way he's playing right now. I just think that he's just taking what he has, which is all what coaching is supposed to be. He's just taking what he has and maximizing it. Nobody thought Dante Pettis could be a player in this league after he's been around for a long time. But he's a player in this league. I love Darnell Mooney. There's so many things you could do with him. I just think he's taking what he has right now, and he's trying to maximize it. It'll be interesting to see how they kind of overcome the loss of, you know, of Khalil Herbert. He's a really, really good back, really tough kid, and breaks a lot of tackles. I got to see what they do with that position this weekend. It's going to be really important. But I just think it's nothing that he did in Green Bay with Aaron Rodgers, that's for sure. And so I just think there is some Lamar Jackson-type runs, but not that many. I mean, quarterback powers and quarterback cracks and things like that, or a lot of teams have those. I just think it's pretty unique with what they're doing to what they have right now.
Brian, we'll let you go. If Getsy was getting a head coaching job somewhere else, would you want him to be your head coach here? Would you choose him over the head coach?
I wouldn't, no. I like Matt Eberflus. I think he's got – I hope they can keep the whole staff together.
Yeah.
I'm sure people will talk to Luke, you know, because of what they're doing with the quarterback, and anybody that's looking to develop a quarterback should look at what he's doing. But, you know, developing a quarterback is one thing. That's great. But, you know, you got 53 guys in a room you got to talk to. So, you know, I don't know how Luke is in front of the whole room, and can he motivate a whole team? They try to do that in Denver. It doesn't look like it's working right now. It's early, but I hope they can keep the staff together, because I think it's a good staff.
Great stuff, Brian. Really appreciate it.
Thanks, Brian.
Yep. All right, guys. You bet.